viewers, this is Professor Dr. Vaseem I Khan from Shri Shivaji Law College, Parbhani, Maharashtra. I welcome all the viewers to the lecture series of Law of Torts. In today's lecture, we will discuss one case law which is a basis of strict liability, and that case law is Ryland versus Fletcher. So let us proceed towards our topic. So we will discuss in gist about the concept of strict liability, which is discussed under the case of Ryland versus Fletcher. There is a situation, there are a certain situation when a person may be liable for some harm even though he is not negligent in causing the same. Ordinarily, the person will be held responsible if his act is a negligent one. But in this particular concept, in the concept of strict liability, the person sometime is not negligent, then, but his liability will arise under the concept of strict liability. Person negligent nahi hone ke bawajood bhi uski liability arise ho sakti hai, wo liable ho sakta hai strict liability mein. There is no intention to cause the harm. Person ka intention bhi nahi hai harm cause karne ka. Sometimes he may even have made a positive effort to avert the same. So sometimes the person has already taken a due care. He has put his all the efforts to avert the same injury. Injury ko bachane ke liye kabhi kabhi person ne effort bhi kiye hue hai. Phir bhi person ki responsibility rahegi strict liability mein. The rule laid down in Ryland versus Fletcher is generally known as the rule of strict liability with certain exception. The rule of strict liability is having a certain exception. So let us proceed towards the specific case law, which is Ryland versus Fletcher. So in this case, the Ryland was a mill owner and the Fletcher was a lessee of coal mine. So in this case, the Ryland was a mill owner and Fletcher was a lessee of coal mine. So defendant constructed a reservoir through the independent contractor. So the Ryland, who was a mill owner, was appointed one independent contractor for the purpose of construction of a reservoir. So mill owner jo tha Ryland, uske manufacturing process ke liye usko water ki zarurat thi. Usne ek independent contractor ko appoint kiya ek artificial reservoir tayar karne ke liye. So this is a particular reservoir which is being constructed by the defendant. जो defendant, ये जो ये particular आपको दिख रहा है, ये जो reservoir था जो defendant construct कर रहा था, defendant through independent contractor construct कर रहा था. So while constructing this particular reservoir, the independent contractor found a certain unused shaft. यहाँ पर ऐसे कुछ shaft थे, hole थे जो independent contractor को मिले, and independent contractor fill those shaft with mud. ये जो shaft थे उसको independent contractor ने negligently mud से, कीचड़ से block किया. And हम जान सकते हैं या हमको पता हो सकता है कि अगर mud से उसको अगर हम pack करेंगे या fill करेंगे तो वो कभी भी फट सकते हैं. तो negligently उसने act किया. When the water filled in this particular reservoir, जब इस reservoir में पानी भरा गया, so the water burst through this shaft. तो ये shaft से water burst हुआ, and it goes to the, ये क्या हुआ फिर? ये गया, ये जो adjacent land में जो था, ये जो coal mines है, plaintiff की, तो ये जो water यहाँ से burst हुआ, it enters to the coal mine. It filled into the coal mine of this particular plaintiff. ये पूरा पानी reservoir का plaintiff के coal mine में यहाँ पर आकर fill हो गया. So plaintiff sustained a loss. Plaintiff filed a suit against the defendant. ये जो plaintiff था, इसने Ryland के against में suit file किया. And he says that कि due to your act, I sustained a loss. But The Ryland took the defense that he has constructed a reservoir through independent contractor and it was the fault of independent contractor. तो यहाँ पर Ryland ने जो defendant था उसने ये defense लिया कि ये जो reservoir है ये construct किया ये independent contractor ने. ये independent contractor ने construct किया हुआ है इसलिए I'm not responsible for that. Because but the independent contractor is responsible. But in this case the court held. यहाँ पर कोर्ट ने हेल्ड किया. द कोर्ट लेट डाउन इन केस दैट द पर्सन हु फॉर हिज ओन पर्पज ब्रिंग्स ऑन हिज लैंड एंड कीप्स देयर एनीथिंग लाइकली टू डू मिसचीफ इट इफ एस्केप्स मस्ट कीप इट इन एट हिज ओन पेरिल. द कोर्ट डिसाइड इन दिस केस दैट हुएवर ब्रिंग्स एनी डेंजरस थिंग ऑन हिज लैंड फॉर हिज ओन पर्पज देन ही मस्ट कीप इट एट हिज ओन पेरिल. अगर कोई पर्सन डेंजरस चीज़ को अपने प्रीमाइसिस में लेकर आता है तो उसको अपने रिस्क पर वहाँ पर उसको रखना पड़ेगा. जब भी अगर वो एस्केप होती है अगर उसके प्रीमाइसिस के बाहर वो निकलती है तो रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी उस पर्सन की ही रहेगी जिस पर्सन ने वो डेंजरस थिंग लेकर आया है. एंड इन दिस केस द डिफेंडेंट वॉज हेल्ड लाइबल फॉर द टॉर्ट ऑफ स्ट्रिक्ट लाइबिलिटी एंड द कोर्ट सेज दैट Whenever the person brings a dangerous thing on his land, he will be held responsible for the tort of strict liability. So these are the particular facts of the Ryland versus Fletcher case. So I hope you like this video, and if you like this video, please hit the like button and like our channel and press the notified button.